and saints of God, how are you doing? I hope that things find you doing well today, resting in Jesus Christ and looking forward to a great day ahead, and not only a great day ahead, but also toward a great week as we begin today on Monday, the first day of the work week, and just rejoicing in Jesus Christ. Had a great day yesterday. Thankful for all that went on yesterday from Sunday school. What a great time in Sunday school. The singing in the church was just absolutely wonderful. And then also the preaching, a lot of liberty in the preaching. And then last night, what a great service with the Puffers. They did a great job at their music. And so it was just a good day to be in the house of God. And, you know, we just love all that the Lord did. I realize that I've been out of commission for 2 weeks here. First of all, Sherry and I were at the pastor's conference, and we enjoyed a great time there. Really got our batteries charged and challenged to face another year. And then also last week, our producer was on vacation, and I don't know how to produce this. And so that's how it happened. But we are back today, and we are so glad to be back online and sharing the Word of God with you this morning, hoping that we can be encouraging and that, you know, today will be a start of a new time in the Word of God. Matter of fact, we're going to do something just a little bit different today. Instead of going back to the book of Joshua, I talked to some different people while we were on this little vacation that we had for 2 weeks here. And different people kind of mentioned to me that maybe it'd be a little bit better if we just kind of did a devotional thought through the week rather than going through the book. And, you know, I'm all for that. We'll see what happens and see how it goes. And so today we're going to be, if you have your Bibles with you, or here Heather will put this passage on the screens for us, John 15:26. There you go. And look what it says here. It says, "But when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceedeth from the Father, he shall testify of me." You know, while I was at the conference this a couple weeks ago, something irritated happened to me. The conference was going on so well. The speakers were tremendous and just a great spirit in the services, and learning a lot of things that we need to know to be armed and ready for things that are coming down the pike that our government is doing to us. And it was just very encouraging and great meetings. Well, we went to breakfast, Sherry and I did, and we were sitting there at breakfast, you know, just a few moments the class would start that we were in. And this lady walks in, she says, "You know, this conference has been wonderful, but why don't they talk about the Holy Spirit? Where's the Spirit stuff? Why don't they talk about the Spirit?" And she just kind of went on for a few moments, and I just figured, you know, don't say anything, just sit still, finish eating your breakfast, and the class will start real soon. But she kind of went on and just kind of said different things, and you know, I knew what she was talking about. She wanted somebody to stand up and speak in tongues. She wanted somebody to go down the aisles barking, you know, or she wanted somebody to be slain in the spirit. She wanted somebody, you know, bunch of junk. And I want to tell you something. It's sad how the world chases after those things. And, you know, and the whole time she was speaking, this kept flashing through my mind. And let me just share it with you. Look what it says here, this last part. Heather will show you the verse again. "He shall testify of me." You know, when we go back and we look at the precious Holy Spirit, and first of all, we need to understand who the Holy Spirit is. He, the Holy Spirit, is God Almighty. I want you to know something. It was a miracle beyond comprehension when Jesus Christ put on flesh and stepped into this world. That's a miracle. You say, I don't understand how God could become flesh, how that somebody can paint a picture and then step into the picture. I don't understand either. We take it by faith. But let me give you another great miracle, that the God creator of heaven and everything else, the Redeemer, can come and live inside me. Man, that is an amazing truth, that inside of me, God lives. And here's the important thing about it. This God that lives inside me that we call the Holy Spirit doesn't testify of himself. He testifies of Jesus Christ. And that's an important thing for you to understand and realize. The Holy Spirit, in a meek and honoring way, he glorifies Jesus Christ in and through our lives. It's not about him getting the praise and the glory. I believe with all my heart that you and I need to know this truth. We have the Holy Spirit living inside of us. He's not God's messenger. He is God. And he brings along with us, or to us, a fellowship. He is fellowshipping with the saints. You and I have the Holy Spirit of God. And I want to tell you something. Yeah, there are times when he's just moving upon me and just I just absolutely love it. And boy, I felt his presence Sunday morning in the services. It was so good and so great. But I want to tell you something. At the end of the day, he's there and he challenges me to come to the place to where I praise Jesus Christ, the Redeemer, the one who saved us for our sins. And I just want you to leave that little thought with you today and think about the goodness of God. Think about God living inside me, fellowshipping with me, but also God inside of me testifying of God who died for me. Amen. So let's have a word of prayer and then we'll go on. Heavenly Father, we love you and thank you for your goodness to us. And Father, we pray that as we start this broadcast back up, that Lord, that you'll be with us and that Father, you will challenge us. Lord, help us to walk in the Spirit truly, Father, as we sing the praises of Jesus Christ. Father, help us to realize it's a miracle that you came into this world. Help us to realize it's a miracle that you came into our hearts and lives. And help us to realize everything about you is miraculous. Lord, we love you and we thank you today. Be with these, my dear friends, and those that are sick today, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Go serve your King. Bye.